What's up, everybody? So basically, I'm showing you today how to do a background for your fish tank. This is the design that I made for my background. I'll make it look like a little kid's painting or whatever it is. See, this is how it looks. So what I did is I did 3 prints for my printer. So I zoomed in the picture to make it more bigger so it could fit the paper. So after that, I'll take this, make 3 parts, which they all connect together. And what I do is, I cut them out like this. Make sure I have the perfect cut. Cut these corners out, all the white parts that you want cut out. And then from there, I'll laminate it. Laminate it before it won't have to get wet next time you take it out from the fish tank when you're ready to wash it or clean it. See, all the edges looking good. Mistake. Well, I put it here. Just give me a second. I'm trying to catch this one little piece right here. And there you go. We have this one piece. Now, once this is cut and we have the other one cut, I can place this right here while I laminate it. And then from there, everything will look cool. Oh, the wrong one. Right there. All right, so let's just start getting these things cut. So what you're going to want to have to do now, you're going to want to laminate it and throw these little pieces out first, scraps, and then we're going to laminate right now, so I'll get back to you. So right now I'm using this laminator. It's a Scotch thermal laminator. So, and I also got the Scotch thermal laminating pouches as well, as you can see right here. And I got some laminating pouches right here. So I took out 3. So I want to make 3 of them. Give me a second. Open this up. And for my first design, I have to do this one first. And then put this one together. See, so it could be like, you know, like this, sorry. Like that. Put this in the middle of the pouch. When you laminate, make sure that the paper that you're printing, that you're laminating, goes directly in the middle and push it all the way on top so it can be all the way on top. Push it all the way on top and center. And you go to laminate it. Let's just leave it like that and it'll laminate on its own. So we'll just sit back and wait. I'll put a high speed feed this week. And there you go. Within a couple of seconds, you have this laminated already. Nice and clean, fresh look. And it's waterproof as well, so you're good. Now we go for the second one. And then right here, as you see, this is your layout. You're gonna have to cut these little clear pouches, laminating already. Get them out, and then it's gonna be put together like this. You're gonna take some tape, tape it in the front and the back, and remember, you're gonna put it behind the tank, not inside the tank with the water. So it's good for reptiles. You can make different prints. Make sure you make it bigger when you print them out. So make sure you have your layouts, it's how it's gonna be cut out. And then from there, you laminate it, and then you're good to go. I'll show you afterwards, once I put it all together, once I cut, I'm gonna cut it out, and I'll show you how it looks after it's all done, okay? So for now, I'm just gonna take my straight cutter, and I'm gonna start cutting all these plastics off. So once you're done with your scotch laminator, make sure you turn it off. And don't start wrapping up the wire right away. Just let it cool down for a few. Give it like 10 minutes before it cools down. Maybe it'll be shorter than that, but just give it to me. I give it up to like 10 minutes before it cools down, before I start wrapping anything up, because it's still hot. So make sure you be safe. So now I got all my layouts, I'm gonna have to start cutting some pieces off and make sure that it all matches up. You could do this if your tank is a 10 gallon tank. So if you have more than a 10 gallon tank, if you have more gallon tanks, like, you know, a 15 or 20 or 50 gallon tank or whatever, you can still do multiple sheets, multiple printouts, and for it to be all put together. Make sure, it doesn't matter if you have, like, this don't match, but once you put this together like this, all you have to do is just make sure you cut up to here. Take a pen, mark it up, and just cut that one piece. But make sure you have an inch left before you cut, because you gotta put the tape on the back. So after that, everything will look cool. This is like a 10 gallon right here, more lightly. So yeah, I'm gonna get back to work and I'll show you what it looks like in the end. And you just start cutting. Place this here. We don't wanna cut all the edges out. Don't cut every single edge. What you do is cut out the bottom edges only, because you have, you know, to have space, so when you're ready to tape it behind your tank. See, you cut out a little piece up to here. This you leave behind, you leave right here, and in this corner you can leave as well. This is where you're gonna tape at. Just cut at least like a half an inch. Much right here, only an inch, half an inch. And then you want to do the same thing as in the ending of the corner, because this is the middle as well. So you do the same thing in the middle. And just cut up just the bottom. And for this side, you leave both sides, because you're going to have to tape it back to back. Matter of fact, you cut this one, this side right here. So you're gonna have to tape it. And the thing is clear, so you can see where you're cutting at. It's easier. Right there. And then do the same thing on the other side as well. Matter of fact, let me see. Alright, that's awesome. Now, let's mark. Now, let's mark where we're gonna have to cut up at. Let me go get a marker. And let's mark where we have to cut up at. Okay, so we head up to here. Now, I'm going to take this side, and I'm going to cut up this corner right here, this whole piece right here, all the way to the tip. So you have your marking right here. Alright. Now we're gonna cut up an inch away. Don't cut all the way to, see, you make two lines right here. One, two, I'll show you. This is where the actual picture is gonna go on. You have a second line where you're gonna cut up. So you need like a little inch or so for when you're taping it, it could touch. You don't wanna do the whole thing. So, give it an inch. And then we have this one piece right here. So now we have this piece with this piece and this inch right here. So now we're gonna cut the rest of this right here, the bottom. And with the end. And over here, we're gonna cut off from the end because this is the ending of the tank. So we just cut off a half an inch. We need more plastic space to tape where you're gonna tape at. So right here, we have everything done here. And this is how everything's placing out. So you have your whole frame right there. So basically, this is gonna fit the tank right here. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna have to tape the front and the two parts in the middles, and then you flip it around and then you place the two parts in the back as well. I'll get back to you once I get the tape. So what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna match up our papers evenly, which I already have it. And cut the estimate of tape. Where we're gonna place our tape at. Pull the two ends like that. And just drop, boom. And it automatically drops right there. At the same time, we'll do the same in the endings of these right here as well. Make sure they match together. Okay, so let's get this matching together. And then from there, we'll tape it. Make sure everything's straight and neat before you start putting any tape on. So it's nice and straight. Take the tape. Measure it. Cut it off with your teeth. And we'll do the same exact thing we did the first time. And boom. There you go. Now, see how everything folds? Everything's folding, you don't want that. We're gonna have to do the same exact thing. With your excess tape that you have right here, just tape right there, place that. Whatever little tape we have left over. And what you're gonna do is, do the same exact thing. Boom, my tape fell. The back don't have to be as perfect as the front, but make sure we fold this in, make sure everything looks nice and clear. Press it down if you have any little bubbles or anything, but and there looks good. Let's do the other side now, which if I can find my tape. I found my tape. So it fell. Now we gotta look. Since it fell, I have to find it. Here it goes. This side, the back side don't have to be that perfect. But from there you go. I have my my background for my fish tank. So now what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna place this on your fish tank. If the corners are big, make sure you take a marker and mark them off, and then you do the same exact thing, cut it with your straight razor. And then from there, the tape behind your fish tank. Well, that's me, I have a turbo, so I put this in my turbo tank. So, I'll show you afterwards. Well, I measured it. As for me, my 10-gallon tank, this was a little too longer, so I measured it, and this is where I want to cut up to. So I'm going to cut all these pieces out, and then it was the same perfect length as my turbo tank. So, from there, let's get this rolling. And this is the same length as my turtle tank. So right now, I'm gonna place this back there to my turtle tank. So I'm gonna have to put some tape back here. And place it on my turtle tank. First, place the tape. And I have a whole bunch of kids' toys on my turtle tank. So let me take these toys out. I'm sorry that the camera was a little foggy. I didn't notice until now. But for now, I'm just gonna place these little things back here. I'll get back to you once I show you. Okay, so now this is how it looks. Looks really awesome. And we got a sticker right here of Jesus and stuff. But this is my son's toys. He has a collection of Toy Story, but this is not part of the video. I just wanted to show you that this is entertaining for our turtle. Look how nice and beautiful the back looks. Great. And instead of looking empty and having a wall back there, this is how the turtle, he looks happy. Look at him. Oh yeah, you like it? Awesome. And from there, yeah, it looks great. Now my son comes over here, he'll stay right here and he'll play with the turtle. Sometimes our cat as well, she'll come visit her brother. And yeah, he looks awesome, he looks excited, and he's happy. Yeah.